Welcome to the session on data mining applications. I am Dr. K. Aditya Shastri. In this session, I will be giving a brief account of what are the different applications in the real world of the data mining. So one of the first applications is data mining for financial data analysis. So all of you can guess here, financial data analysis means it includes banking services such as loans, investments, credits, debit, etc. So in this, how the data mining can help? Initially, before the mining is applied, you need to design and construct data warehouses for multi-dimensional data analysis and data mining. So this was repeated, but in the previous classes, sessions, again, I will tell the data warehouse is nothing but a large repository of data collected from heterogeneous sources. Now you need to construct this data warehouse in such a way that the data stored in this data warehouse can be analyzed or mined in different dimensions. Multi-dimensional views can be produced. So data warehouses need to be constructed for banking and financial data. For example, one may like to view the debt and revenue changes by month, by region, or by sector, along with maximum, minimum, average, trend, and other statistical information. So whatever view you want, or whatever angle you want to view the data, financial data, the data warehouse should make it available. And after the data warehouse is constructed, then you can easily apply the mining algorithms. So where this data mining algorithm can help in financial data analysis? One is loan payment prediction and customer credit policy analysis. So as you can name itself indicates, predicting whether the customer will pay the loan or not. Okay, how you can predict? Based on his history or based on his attributes, correct? So here you see data mining methods like attribute selection and attribute relevance ranking may help identify important factors and eliminate irrelevant ones. Okay, so here, for example, loan to value ratio is there, term of loan is there, debt ratio, payment to income, education level, all these attributes can be considered for predicting whether the person will be successfully repaying the loan or not. So it is called as credit score. You can assign a credit score to that person using mining algorithms and then predict whether he will pay the loan or not. One of the your seniors have done this project called customer credit risk prediction, in which they have used different mining algorithms, and they found that the regression model was working well here. So another application in this financial data analysis is classification and clustering of customers for targeted marketing. So even banks require customers, right? They need account holders. For that, they target some customers who can invest more money in their bank. So such type of prediction can be identified, or such type of customers can be identified by using mining. That's what it says here. For example, identifying most crucial factors influencing the customer's decision regarding banking. Then detection of money laundering and other financial crimes. To detect money laundering information from multiple databases like transaction databases, federal or state crime history databases, as long as they are potentially related. So if you understand, this money laundering means the money is squandered or distributed in such a way that the source of the money is not known. So who has squandered the money, who has laundered the money, who has distributed the money is not known. To detect that, this mining algorithms can be used. And other financial crimes are there, like credit card frauds are there, correct? They can be predicted by detecting unusual patterns, correct? Such as large amounts of cash flow at certain periods by certain customers. Okay, so here are some useful tools like data visualization, etc. can be used. Coming to the second application of data mining, it can be used in retail. What is retail? Retail is concerned with data on sales, shopping, goods, consumption, etc. So whatever data is related to sales and these things that they have mentioned, they come under the retail data. Now, how it can be used here? One way is analysis of effectiveness of sales campaign. So mining can be used to improve the company's profits. It can be used to analyze the data in multiple dimensions. Similarly, association analysis can also be used, correct, to particularly predict which items the customers will purchase together. Then another one is customer retention. So we want to retain a customer. He has purchased in Amazon. So the next time the Amazon wants to retain the customer, he should not go to some other site like Flipkart or eBay. So how to retain a customer? That can be analyzed using the mining algorithms. Then this is an important application, product recommendations and cross-referencing of items. So this was repeated in various slides. So if you remember, product recommendation means, suppose the customer has purchased a particular product, then similar products can be recommended to the customer in his Gmail account or through his mobile, so that the profit of that particular company, e-commerce company, will be increased. Then one of the third applications of data mining is in telecommunication industry. So telecommunication industry or telecom industry services include fax, pagers, cell phones, email, telephone, etc. Right? So this is the data, all the mobile data, fax data, email data, all come under this telecom data. So how this mining will help there? So basically the data mining, in this case DM short form they are used. In telecom, it can be used to detect fraud activities, okay, identify telecom patterns and improve the quality of service. Fraudulent activities in calling might happen, right? Not only in financial, but here in telecommunication industry also fraud might happen, like unknown user might create havoc, or as nowadays fake messages are coming. So how to detect whether that message is fake or not? So those things can be huge application. In telecom industry, mining algorithms can be used for that. Then multi-dimensional analysis of telecom data. What is this? Telecom data are multi-dimensional, correct? Because the telecom data can have calling time is there, then the duration is there, location is there, type of call is there. So you can view the telecom data from multiple dimensions. So analysis, multi-dimensional analysis of such data can be used to identify and compare data traffic, correct? Then the workload on the system, then the, how the resource is used, what is the profit, correct? So analysts may wish to regularly view the charts and graphs, correct, and predict the time of day usage. All these things can be done. Multiple dimensional analysis can be done. Hence, it is useful to consolidate telecom data into large data warehouses and perform multi-dimensional analysis using online analytical processing and visualization tools. So multiple views can be given for the same data so that it can be helped for mining. So another one is in the telecommunication industry, the mining can be used to detect frauds, correct? What I had explained before, and identification of unusual patterns, unwanted calls, false messages, correct? They can be detected using data mining. So all these can give you an idea for your final year projects. Because each one of these applications can be used in your final year projects. Mobile telecommunication services. So another application is in mobile telecommunication services. So if you want to predict why at a certain particular time the mobile traffic is busy, so it might mean that some fishy activity is going on, some suspicious activity might be going on. All these things can be predicted, provided you have the cellular data available. The fourth application is in the biological data analysis. See, actually this is still in a preliminary stage, but this has a major application. And now currently, as all of you are aware, that this coronavirus is creating havoc around the world. So if sophisticated data mining algorithms are developed, okay, the genomic sequence of the coronavirus may be identified and it can be prevention measures or treatment can be predicted. So that's a huge actually application area here in current scenario. Before that, what is this biological data? It deals with genomics, okay, sequence of genes, proteomics, sequence of proteins, etc. Comparison and identification of human genomes and other species, new pharmaceuticals, cancer therapies, etc. Now this biological data mining actually is a new field, but it has huge potential because it is actually dealing with biological data which consists of genes, correct, DNA, etc. So gene is a collection of nucleotides, ACGT. Even a small change in this sequence will completely change the genetic structure of the individual, right? So this genome sequence represents the sequence of alphabets. So similarly, proteome is a set of protein molecules in a cell, tissue, or organism. So basically, the data mining algorithm along with the domain expert has a huge potential here. So this project was not done in by your seniors or anybody. So I think some of you can go ahead and try to get an idea how to mine biological data. So how this data mining can contribute in biological data analysis? One is semantic integration of heterogeneous distributed genomic and proteomic databases. So to do the cross-site analysis of biological data, to find the correct linkages, correct, between the biological data, it can be used. This is basically the association analysis can be used, where you want to associate different genes, right, and their similarities. Then another one is alignment indexing similarity search and comparative analysis of multiple nucleotide or protein sequences. So here actually what he does is he tries to basically identify or search similar type of genes or similar type of protein sequences so that it can be grouped together. Then discovery of the structural patterns can also be done. Continuing with this biological data analysis, another is association and path analysis. So this is what is you have studied. Association means you want to associate some object with another object, relate one object with another object, link one object with another object. So in this case, since we are dealing with biological data, this represents identifying co-occurring gene sequences to different stages of disease development, right? Nowadays, coronavirus is creating havoc. Now, what type of gene sequence is causing that havoc? If you are able to associate that, naturally, prevention or treatment can be easily identified, of course, with the help of the doctors, domain experts. And as you can see, most diseases are triggered by a combination of genes acting together. So in this case, association analysis can be used to determine kinds of genes that are likely to co-occur in target samples. So which type of genes has triggered the disease? If the mining algorithm is able to identify, okay, naturally it will help in the treatment of that particular disease. And pharmaceutical interventions, correct? If sequence of genetic activities across the different stages of disease development can be identified, right? The coronavirus, for example, it is mutated. It is a mutated virus. Now, if you are able to identify which gene was mutated, and for that, if you are able to identify the pharmaceutical remedy, then effective treatment of that particular disease can be done. Then visualization means how do you picture the particular biological data once you have mined. So basically, because it is a highly technical, right? The gene sequence is technical, the mining algorithm is technical. Now the end user has to understand it, because the doctor or the person who is seeing the result, he will not be a technical expert. So you can use here visual data mining, right? That will provide the genetic data analysis in the form of easy graphs or picture. Data mining in other scientific applications. Data mining can be used in other scientific domains like geosciences, astronomy, meteorology, chemical engineering, okay, fluid dynamics, structural mechanics, etc. Then one of the major applications is this one, data mining for intrusion detection. Actually, if you see intrusion detection, it can be considered a virus attack, or it is a set of actions that threaten the integrity or confidentiality of a network. Any attack on the network, okay, it is called as intrusion detection. To identify this intrusion, data mining can help. How it can help? See, it can be used for misuse detection, correct? Which will be identified or labeled as either normal or intrusion. Then a classifier can be built which will detect the known intrusions. Then association and correlation analysis and aggregation can be done, right? What is the use of aggregation association here? So association and correlation mining can be applied to find the relationships between system attributes describing the network that can provide insight regarding selection of useful attributes for intrusion selection. See, basically what he is telling here is you want to associate which attributes of the network, okay, are vulnerable to the intrusion. If you are able to associate, naturally those resources, network resources, can be safeguarded. Continuing with this data mining for intrusion detection, one way is it can be used for analysis of stream data. So what is this stream data? Stream data means actually it is nothing but the packets that will be sent between in the computer network, right? You studied computer network, so you'll know the terminologies here. Now, how do you analyze the stream data? Basically, why we need to analyze the stream data? To detect the malicious events or to detect identifiers. Okay. Then distributed data mining. Intrusions can be launched from several different locations and targeted to many different locations. This is of course a major problem, as you can know, the due to the technology and advancement, the particular attacks can be initiated from different sources. So in such a case, the distributed data mining algorithms can be used to detect the attacks, distributed attacks. Then visualization tools again can be used to project the data mining results to the end user, because the security analysts again are not technical experts. They don't know about they may not know about the data mining algorithms, so they will just see the screen and detect. The user interface has to be good and the visualization has to be effective. So basically, he has given here, in comparison to the traditional intrusion detection systems, intrusion detection systems that is designed based on the data mining algorithms are more accurate. Okay. So in this session, basically we have studied some 5 to 6 applications of data mining in the real world. And for engineering students, basically each one of the application can be taken as a data mining project in their BE course. As well as for any aspiring data scientists, each one of these applications provide a innovative idea in the direction of data mining projects that they want to do. Thank you.